Students, we are going to study chapter 1 of class 6 science, food, where does it come from? The topics to be covered in this chapter are food and its importance, variety of food, ingredients of food, sprouted seeds, sources of food, and types of organisms on the basis of their food habits. Let's start our first topic, food and its importance. You know very well that we need energy to carry out different activities. We also need different materials for growth and development of our body. For example, carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, and water. And all these materials are called nutrients. So what are nutrients? The materials required for energy, growth, and development are called nutrients. Now, what is food? Food is the basic source of nutrients. The nutritious things which we eat for obtaining nutrients is called food. We can also define food as a substance which is eaten daily to provide energy to our body. In this picture, you can see that these activities are being performed, and for performing all these activities, food is required. So, food is required for development, growth, and energy. On the other side, various nutritious things are shown here which we eat for obtaining the nutrients which make up the food, the basic source of nutrients. So, nutrients are the materials required for growth and maintenance of our body, like carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals, and water. Importance of food. All living beings need food. But why? Food is needed by all for the following main purposes. First of all, food provides energy for doing work. It helps us to perform our daily activities. It helps in growth and development of our body. It keeps us healthy. It provides resistance and protection against diseases and infections. And it helps in the repair and replacement of the damaged tissues. This compiles our first topic, importance of food. Variety of food. What do you mean by variety? That means different types of items, different types of choices which we have in front of us. Different people have different choices of food. There is a wide range of food items eaten across various states of India. People of different states eat different kinds of food. And different countries also eat different kinds of food. Now, in this picture, you can see that so many food items are shown here which belong to different states, like idli, dosa sambar. They belong to mainly South Indian states. And dal roti belongs to the North Indian states. It's a North Indian dish mainly. Machar jhol and mishti doi and also rasagulla are famous from West Bengal. Litti chokha is famous in Bihar. And dal bati churma is a dish from Rajasthan. Makki ki roti and sarso da saag, you know very well that it is mainly a dish which is eaten in Punjab. Even in the same state or place, different families have different food habits. We should include fruits, vegetables, pulses, cereals, eggs, dairy products, and a variety of nutrients in our food, because single food does not provide all the nutrients. So take care that whenever you take your meal, different types of nutrients should be there in your food so that you can get a balanced diet. Now we'll take our next topic, ingredients of food. What do you mean by ingredients? Ingredients are all those things, those materials that are needed, or you can say that are required to prepare a particular type of dish. For example, for making dal, we require pulses, water, oil, salt, and spices. So these are the ingredients for making a dal. You can see in this picture also that the ingredients of making dal are shown here. Pulses, water, salt, oil may be required or may be not. It depends on the person to person, and spices like turmeric and chili or
also used in making a dal. So these are the ingredients for making a dal. Similarly, the ingredients for making rice will be only two, that are raw rice and water. We can make cooked rice by making only these two ingredients, using only these two ingredients, which are raw rice and water. But if we want to make rice in pulao form, vegetable pulao or vegetable biryani, tahari, so many names are given to this pulao. So for making this pulao, we will add some vegetables like peas, onion, tomato, etc., salt and some spices also, along with raw rice and water. So in this picture, it is shown the ingredients of cooked rice, that is raw rice and water. By using these, we can make it. Now the topic is sprouted seeds. The seeds which grow white thread-like structures when soaked in water for few hours and kept for 1 to 3 days are called sprouted seeds or sprouts. Remember that only the whole seeds can become sprouts, not the broken one. We should eat sprouted seeds as they are very rich in nutrients. Now let us perform an activity for making sprouts. How can we make sprouts? So in this activity, we'll in the first step take some dry seeds of whole moong dal or chana, gram you can say. You can say any whole seed to make sprout besides these also. Now in step 2, put a small quantity of seeds in a container filled with water and leave this aside for few hours or a day. Now in step 3, on the next day, drain the water completely and leave the seeds in the vessel. Wrap them with a piece of wet cloth and set aside. Children, there can be different methods of keeping these seeds without water. After draining the water, you can wrap them with a piece of wet cloth also, or you can keep them in an airtight container also. Now in step 4, after one day or maybe after 2-3 days, we will observe that a small white thread-like structure has grown out of the seeds. This means that the seeds have sprouted. They have become sprouts. The time of sprouting depends upon the weather. As in summers, seeds take less time to become sprouts, while in winters, they will take more time. So maybe after one day you can see the sprouts, or maybe the second day, or maybe the third day, depending upon the weather. After washing these sprouts, you can eat them. They can also be boiled, and some spices and salt may be added to make them tasty. As you wish, you can eat them in any way. Now you can see in this picture that moong dal and its sprouts are shown here, while in the second picture, chana and its sprouts are seen here. Now we come to the next topic, sources of food. The organisms from which we obtain food are called sources of food. Our food comes from different sources. You must be knowing that different types of food you are eating, they are coming from either plants or animals. So plants and animals are the two main sources of food. First, we'll study about the plants as a source of food. Plants are a major source of food for us, as they provide us cereals. For example, wheat, rice, maize. These are the cereals which you eat. You eat chapati of wheat, you eat rice and maize in different forms. So these are the cereals which we get from plants. Second, pulses. For example, moong, gram, beans, different type of pulses you eat daily. These are a very good source of proteins. Then vegetables. For example, potato, onion, cauliflower and different other types of vegetables you eat. Now fruits. For example,
apple, mango, banana, so many fruits we get from plants. Spices, different types of spices we get from plants like turmeric, chili, coriander and several other spices which make the food tasty. Vegetable oils are the other products which we get from plants. For example, mustard oil we take, sunflower oil, groundnut oil, soybean oil, so many oils, vegetable oils or fats we get from plants. Then another thing which is very important which we get from plants is sugar. Sugar we get from sugar cane and sugar beet plants. In the given picture, you can see the different types of plant products which we get from plants. Vegetables, fruits, grains, that means cereals, pulses, spices, oil and sugar. Now, edible parts of the plants. There are several parts of the plants which we can eat. Those parts of a plant which are eatable are called edible parts of the plant. The following are the parts of plants that can be eaten as food. First of all, roots. For example, radish and carrot, which we eat in the form of vegetables, are the root part of the plant. They are the roots of the plant. They grow under the ground, under the soil. Then stem, for example, potato and sugarcane. This is sometimes children get confused that potato is also a root, but it is not a root. Though it is grown under the soil, but it is the stem part of the plant. Potato, sugarcane are the stem part and several other we can give the examples. Now flowers, rose, cauliflower, these are the flowers part of the plant which we eat. Rose can be used as gulab jal and in several other ways it is eaten. Gulkand also is made of rose. Now fruits, so many fruits we get from plants, apple, grapes, banana, mango, you can name many of them. Leaves, spinach and cabbage are the leaves part of the plant. The cabbage, the vegetable which you eat are the leaves part. Spinach, you very good source of iron, it is the leaf part of the plant. Seeds, the cereals which we take, which we eat, the wheat, rice, etc. are the seeds part of the plant. And several others like mustard also you can say. These are the seeds of the plant which we eat. So these were the edible parts of the plant. In the given picture you can see the parts of the plant. Now we come to our next topic, next part, animals as a source of food. Animals are also a major source of food for us. We eat animals in the form of meat. Several people take animals in the form of meat, as well as their different products like milk, eggs and honey. We can say that animals provide us meat. For example, we get meat from hen, goat, fish, etc. Many other animals are eaten in the form of meat. Then eggs we get from hen, duck, etc. Fowl also is there. Then honey, we get honey from honeybees. Honeybees make honey and we use that in several forms. Now the most important one for you is the milk and milk products which we get from animals. These are very important for the human beings and especially the children. Milk and milk products like curd, butter, ghee, cheese, cream, etc. And we get these from cow, buffalo, goat and camel also. So these were the sources, animals as a source of food. In this picture, you can see that different types of sources of food from animals are given here. Milk, meat, eggs, chicken, fish. And on the other side, it is shown that different food items form a single kind of food. Single kind of food matlab means milk. So in this picture, we can see that From milk, we are getting butter, cheese, cream, curd, ghee. The single food is providing so many things for us. Now, in our last topic of this chapter, we'll talk about honey. We get honey from honeybees. Now, what is honey? Honey is a sweet substance in liquid form prepared by honeybees from the nectar of flowers. Now, you can say, what is nectar? You can ask, what is nectar? Nectar is the sweet juice found in flowers. In all the flowers, there is a sweet juice present that is called nectar. The honeybees suck them and make honey for us. Honey consists of water, sugar, minerals and enzymes. It is easily digestible and used as a sweetener and as an antiseptic in medicines. So honey is very beneficial for us. It is used in several Ayurvedic medicines also, and it should be taken for keeping our digestive system okay. Now, production of honey. How is honey produced? How is honey made? Honeybees suck the nectar from flowers of the plant. They modify it inside their body to make it in honey form, to make honey. Nectar is changed into honey in the body of the honeybees by the honeybees. Now, this prepared honey is stored in beehive. Where do they store it? Honey is stored in beehive. What is beehive? Beehive is the home of honeybees. So, honeybees store their self-made honey in their homes, which is beehive. Now, how is honey extracted? How do we get honey from this beehive? Extraction of honey. Honey is extracted from beehive either manually or with the help of an artificial extractor. So, the human beings take out the honey from the beehive either manually or they take the help of some artificial extractor also. Now, we'll study about types of organisms on the basis of their food habits. That is, the classification of animals on the basis of their food habits. What is food habit? The habit of an individual owing to which it takes a particular type of food depending on its taste and availability is called food habit. Different organisms eat different kinds of food. On the basis of their food habits, animals are classified into following three groups. First is herbivores, second carnivores, and the third is omnivores. Now, we'll study about them in detail. First of all, herbivores. Animals which eat only the plants or the plant products like fruits, flowers, seeds, etc. are called herbivores. We can also call them herbivorous animals. For example, cow, deer, rat, elephant, etc. Second group is of carnivores. Animals which eat only other animals are called carnivores. That is, the flesh-eating animals are called carnivores. We can also call them carnivorous animals. For example, lion, tiger, eagle, etc. The third group of animals is of omnivores. Animals which eat both plants and their products as well as other animals are called omnivores. That is, they eat both plants as well as other animals. We can also call them omnivorous animals. For example, human beings, we eat all the things. We are vegetarian also and non-vegetarian also. So, we are omnivores. Cat, crow, etc. In this picture, you can see the three groups of animals and their food, which is shown here. In the first picture, herbivorous animals are shown, which eat only plant products. In the second picture, carnivorous animals are shown, which eat the flesh of other animals. And in the third picture, omnivorous animals are shown, which eat both of them, that means plant and plant products as well as the flesh of other animals. Human beings are also shown here, as we are omnivores. Now, that's all. Thanks.